Hello everyone, Warthog Knife Sharpening here. Today we're going to be working on this axe, or it's a hatchet head. Shut this off. So we're going to be working on this hatchet head. It looks like I've already done a little bit of grinding on it in the past. First thing I want to do is going to want to mark the edge with the Sharpie. What this will do is we're going to check for angle right here, right off the get-go, to make sure we're closely matching the angle that's on this hatchet head. So we'll take our Sharpie, get both sides, try to get the full bevel if you can, that way when you start pulling, matching your angle, you can tell if you're taking the full bevel or not. So we'll mark that up pretty good. Okay. So now we're going to want to take this. So the way this jig works for the Tormek T8 is it's got a couple holes in here. This axe jig will slide on here. And then you'll set it in there, and that'll hold your angle true every time on the wheel. So what we're going to do is we mark this edge with some Sharpie. So we're going to set it in here, center it on the jig. Make sure this piece here is laying flat. Okay. Before we turn it on, we're going to make a couple passes. You can go either way. What we're going to see, if our angle is pretty correct, looks like we might need to come up just a hair. Let's see what happens. Let's just try coming up. Let me loosen that, loosen that. Okay. Came up a little bit. Okay, so now we're going to make a few more pulls on here and see how it's cutting. Looks like we may have gone the wrong way. So maybe we needed to go down. Let's try that. Let's go the other way. Get that set down, we'll tighten this up. We'll spin our wheel, we'll move it to another spot. Let's take a look at it. Now we're not hitting the edge, we went too far, so let's come back up a little bit. So we'll loosen these up. We're going to come back up. Tighten this. Let's go over to kind of this side. We'll check it over here. That looks pretty close to, I think we're going to try to stick with that. So we'll fire up our Tormek and get the wheel spinning. We already put water in our pan here. We have it firmly against our jig. We have it on our slide rail. The way that this rig is kind of radiused, I'm going to move the axe head in that same manner. Warthog Knife Sharpening. Thank you everybody for watching. Let's take a look at it. Okay. Looking pretty good. We're just going to keep polishing or keep grinding. Thank you everybody for watching. This is a hatchet head. Got the handle for it right here. So this stone that we have on our Tormek T8 is made of aluminum oxide. This is a 10-inch stone. It's got a stone dresser that comes with the machine. And on one side, it'll make the wheel about a 200 grit. And on the other side, you can make the wheel about a 1000 grit. Okay, let's take a look at it, see if we're grinding. Oh yeah, looking much better. You can see there's still a little bit of Sharpie in that corner. We're gonna grind until we get all new on this side, and then we'll flip over and do the other side. Make sure each time you lay that in there that it's laying right on your flat on your jig. So. You do a little more work in the corners. Where's everybody tuning in from? Let me know in the comments. So this rail system on here is super nice because it allows you to hold the same angle every time instead of trying to freehand it. But you can get something sharp freehanding it, but it's nice having this jig to make sure you're holding a true angle every pass. Okay, let's take another look. Wipe this down, wipe the water off. Okay. Hopefully that's showing up for you guys over there on the camera. You see a little bit of Sharpie left in this area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip the hatchet head or axe head around. This side we had marked it with Sharpie. So we're going to start grinding on this side now, and then we'll come back and finish tuning up this other side. Thank you everyone for watching War Dog Knife Sharpening. So again, we'll bring our axe jig in, center it over the wheel, start grinding. Back and forth motion. Being that the end of this one is such a radius, I think it works best just to use the radius motion instead of going side to side. Because I could go side to side, but the shape of the axe head or hatchet head is round. It's kind of rounded a little bit. So that's when swinging it like this, you get that nice rounded look to it. So we'll just keep working on this side for a minute, kind of like we did the other side. When we get into these corners, you got to tilt the other end up just a little bit. Make sure you get the corner nice and good. You may have to move it over a little bit if it's not centered on your wheel. Make sure you're centered in your jig system here. If you're off just a hair, you can move it. Okay. You can hear the stone doing its work as you move along. How are you guys sharpening your hatchet heads, your axe heads? Doing it by hand? Do you have a grinder? Belt sander? Okay, we're going to want to take a look at it. See what we're doing to that side. Okay, so still got a little bit to work there, there, a little bit all the way across. We'll spend another minute on this side, then we'll go back to the other side. It's a Tormek T8. Four Dog knife sharpening. Thank you everybody for watching. Please hit the like and subscribe button if you want to see more. We're just going to flip it over now, go to the other side, lay it flat on our jig, center it the best we can, and then center your jig on your whetstone, your wheel, and then we'll repeat the same thing, just going side to side. So we did rough up our wheel here before we started. We used the Tormek dressing stone. We gave it the rough edge. So the whole time I'm doing this, I'm holding pressure down to make sure I get a steady grind, a nice and even grind. If you're not holding pressure, then you're going to end up with an uneven grind. So by holding pressure, you can keep it nice and steady, the same amount of pressure the whole time, both sides. Okay, let's flip it around, go back to the other side, lay it flat on our jig, bring it down. We're wanting to form a new apex on here, so we're going to grind and grind and grind until we get to all new metal. You can still see a little bit right there of the old steel. Thank you everybody for watching. So I'm just going to work back and forth, back and forth. Other side. Always swing this out of the way if you're not using it. Wipe that off. As you can see, looks like we're tuning up our edge pretty good. Still see some Sharpie in the corners. I still see some on this side all the way across. So we're just going to keep working it. But hopefully you can see from that far away with the camera. Let's keep going a little longer. We'll get there. War Dog knife sharpening. Sharpening with the Tormek T80. We'll just work it nice and evenly across. Spend a little more time wherever you need to. Looks like it's going to be the corners that need the most amount of time. Excuse me. Back and forth, back and forth. If you need to work one spot for a little bit, let it grind. This corner needs a little bit of work. Just let it sit there for a second. Not gonna hurt anything. Just let it do its work. Okay. Looking better, but still need work. We'll flip it around. So for those of you that are just tuning in, we're working on this hatchet head on the Tormek T8. You got to stay focused on what you're doing if you're ever using these power tools. You don't want to take your eyes off it for too long. Stay focused. Looks like slow and steady always wins the race, so just keep going after it. These corners need a little more work. I can feel some of the burr rolling off of there. Just like sharpening a knife, you've got to form a burr to get it sharp. All new metal. Your corners aren't touching, you may have to apply a little bit of pressure there to get it to do what you want it to do. Okay. Cruise back along here nice and slow. Corner needs a little bit of work, so I'm going to leave it right here for a second. Come back. Okay, at this point, we'll flip it back around. As you can see, we're not really catching that corner very well. But we're almost there. Getting sharp. So we'll keep working on it. Again, every time make sure you're laying flat on your axe jig. This is just like a small axe head. It's a hatchet that I got. Hopefully you guys can see this all right. Thank you for watching. Anything special you guys want to see sharpened, let me know. See if we can make it happen. Come out to the corner, leave it here for a second, let it grind. Okay, we'll swing back. Remember to keep everything consistent. Whatever you do to one side, do the same thing to the other side. Right there, I feel some roughness. I'm sure that's burr being drug off of there, or drug back. Okay, back around. Going to work back and forth. Please like and subscribe if you guys want to see more videos like this. Okay, right now we're starting to come out of our jig a little bit, so we're going to recenter. It does walk around whenever you're moving it back and forth. It wants to walk out of there a little bit, so you just got to focus and pay attention. It's coming too far out, fix it. After we get done sharpening it, we'll clean the edge up. We'll probably do it on the leather wheel here instead of using a hand strop. I'm not sure yet. Probably use that. War Dog knife sharpening. Okay, I'm gonna flip it back around. Let me wipe it off so we can take a look at it real quick. See if we're getting anywhere. You guys can see that all right. It's cleaning up. Let's check the other side. Yeah, it's looking good. So we'll keep working on it. Need to straighten it out just a little bit. But that'll come with the grinding. There's a little bit of Sharpie I still see in that corner. It's going to take a little more grinding there. You can see some of these spots are a little longer. It's a little thinner here and a little thinner there. So those spots need a little more grinding to get that nice even bevel. So here we go. Let's do some more grinding. Nice and flat on my jig. Been trying to find a good camera angle, something that works good for filming what I'm doing here. Thank you guys for sticking with me and watching my videos. So thank you for subscribing. Okay, let's go to the other side. War Dog knife sharpening. The last time I sharpened one of these, dropped it, it was super sharp. You could cut paper with it. It was had a really nice edge on it. Pretty much a razor edge. Which is what this one's gonna have when we get done with it. What method are you guys using to sharpen your axes? Again, the corners are probably going to need more work. Any spots that do need more work, spend extra attention there. Sharpening, you got to pay attention to detail. A lot of it, what you're doing, is you got to do it by eye. So you got to stay focused. This Tormek, the water that you're seeing right here is coming out of a tray we have down here on the bottom that has a magnet on it. So as the metal is coming off of my blade, it's going down into there and being stored up against the magnet. Hey Trapper, how are you doing? Okay, so back and forth, I'm gonna flip it around. Go back to the other side. We're almost there. I see a little bit of Sharpie here. Yeah, we're getting there. So, a few more minutes. This is axe sharpening. A lot of guys are using these little hatchets for bushcraft work. Are you guys into bushcraft stuff? If you are, let me know. Do some more hatchet stuff and more axes. In that corner, I can feel a little bit of thump in there. I can tell that it's doing a little bit of grinding, trying to get it all even. Come back across. Okay, almost there on that side. This side's looking really good too. In about 5 more minutes, I think we'll be ground down to where we want to be. Thank you everybody for staying watching. War Dog Knife Sharpening. Just grinding away at this hatchet head. With this one, we don't want a flat edge on it because it was kind of radiused, and so we're swinging it. Swing it back and forth instead of keeping it flat. Corners are where I've been needing the most work. Go back to the other side. So whenever we drop this, we're not going to do it on this video. We'll make another video, or I don't even know if we'll do it on video or not, but if you can hear that clicking in the corners there. Definitely is doing a little more work there. Okay, we're going to swing it back to the other side, nice and slow, nice and steady. Since the corners need the most work, I'm leaving it in the corners for a minute. Feel that thumping going on. You can even go back into a corner. I'm losing my edge or my grip there. It's coming out of this. So hopefully you can see it. Got a little bit of Sharpie there. But other than that, it's really starting to shine up, getting a nice edge on it. And then when we strop it, it'll polish that edge. Well, not done yet, but we're going to stop for a minute. Take a little break. Thank you guys for watching. This is War Dog Knife Sharpening. Here's the handle for this. Oh, let me see. Yeah, here was our handle. We'll have to put that back together when we get done. We're going to probably wind up cleaning some of the rust off of here and putting some oil on this, clean it up a little bit. But we're not quite finished. Like I was saying, there's a little bit of Sharpie right here. But it is getting that razor edge on it. So thank you everybody for watching. This is War Dog Knife Sharpening. If you want to see more, like and subscribe.